today's adventure vlog, me and the lady friend have come to Portsmouth, Maine.
New Hampshire.
To visit... What? We're in New Hampshire still?
Yes.
Oh, shit.
Jon's adventure vlog.
Hello and welcome to Jon's adventure vlog. On today's episode, me and Rebecca are visiting the Strawbery Banke Museum in, where are we? Is it Portsmouth, New Hampshire or Portsmouth,
yes.
Maine?
Portsmouth, New Hampshire.
All right, but there is a Portsmouth, Maine, right?
And it's Portland, like just... Maine.
Oh, well, this screwed me all up. Anyway, apparently it's kind of like old-timey recreation museum village. You know how pilgrims and old guys used to live? From what I understand, it neither contains strawberries or a functioning bank. So we'll see where the disappointment goes from here. All right, so where are we going now? What house is this?
This is the Victorian mansion.
It looks like one. All right, so we just go in? Welcome. Please come in. Goodwin House, built 1811.
The Goodwin Mansion, between 1832 and 1896, home of Civil War Governor Ichabod Goodwin and his wife, Sarah Parker Rice Goodwin.
Cool. Let's keep walking around. So is this the kitchen? Or... I don't know what this room is. Bedroom's nice looking. I gotta say, this birdhouse over here is probably the most luxurious birdhouse I've ever seen for the winged creatures. Look at that thing. It's like, it literally is a small mansion just for birds. If I was a bird, I'd drop my seed there. Becca, you were just telling me that you can trick-or-treat here.
Yeah, next
on Halloween.
Mm-hmm.
And I kind of want to come back, because like going through these streets
would
on Halloween
so
night,
cool.
That would be really cool. That would be kind of creepy, scary,
it's
too.
$6, I mean, I think.
That'd be really neat. I mean, just look at this place. It'd be awesome for Halloween.
What I really love most about all these old houses is not only do they have like, you know, really great furniture and ornate decorations, but every single room has a fireplace. Like, literally every room has its own fireplace. There's two in the building, and there's a fireplace on both sides of both chimneys, so... 8 rooms, 8 fireplaces. That's some good way to heat right there.
Okay, so at the risk of sounding like I complain all the time, I do want to point out something that always kind of annoys me when I go to any museum, really.
I didn't need, like, a whole long-winded speech, either. Like,
yeah.
More than, like, bullet points, you know?
Yeah. Well, that's the thing. That's what the plaques are there for. That's why if you want to learn, you can. But it's just, it's impossible not to be rude about it. It's supposed to be like, no, sorry, I don't want to hear you talk about this. I know it's your job, but I just want to look at the rooms and the fireplaces. Please be quiet so I can keep going. And that's I think that's what annoys me most. Not that they volunteer the information, that there's no real way to get out of it. You're trapped.
This is a Jewish house.
This White House is a Jew house? Oh, sorry, let's go check it out.
It seems that the foods we grew up with seem to be traditional now on special days, holidays, Shabbos, celebrations, things like that.
Well, thank you for the quick tour.
You're very welcome.
Thank you.
Oh, honey, there's your living tour. That was nice. It is weird, though.
A little strange.
It's an interesting thing interacting with the living, you know, because, you know, they're pretending they're from, you know, 100 years ago, and you're pretending you're not holding a camera from the future. Sweet. There's a corner store. Let's go on that one. Anyway, so we just exited the general store, which is a quaint trip down memory lane. It's very funny to see, you know, Heinz ketchup available for 9 cents and Campbell's soup for 12 cents. All the old logos and 40s style foods. Pretty cool. So I guess the Living Museum pretty much goes from like the 1700s all the way up to, you know, 60 years ago. And you don't hear much about it, but this building over here behind me, the Woman House, is where they kept all the females in the village until it was time to cook. But there it is. You know, it's proof of it. I'm here now in the Sherborne House, which is one of the English houses, one of the oldest ones on the lot. And you can't help but think to yourself, well, this is a museum today, but 200 years from now, would your house be a museum? Would people bother to look through your stuff and sit on your 200-year-old couch? I don't know, probably not. But hey, 200 years ago, this house is nothing. It's some dude's house. Nothing special about it. Okay, so we have like one house left to explore, and it's like the oldest, creepiest, most rundown on the compound. And Becca's like scared to go in it, but at the same time, I don't know why, you have this morbid curiosity. I'm like, whatever, we'll just skip it. It's not a big deal. It's just another house. We're gonna go in it.
And I see already this house looks a lot better than it did on the outside. I guess the upkeep is mostly interior.
It's pretty interesting. You get, instead of shutters for a window, you have
built-in shutters.
You like pocket doors. Pretty cool for the creepy house.
The only thing I thought was interesting in the creepy house was this window here of artifacts found, which includes a Mickey Mouse figurine. I don't know, maybe you guys think that's as weird as I do, but Mickey Mouse is an artifact? I mean, he's not that old.
Alright, so that concludes our visit to the Strawbery Banke Living Historical Museum / neighborhood of old houses. I had a good time. We're gonna go out to dinner now, because I am starving. Anyway, folks, that does it for this episode of Jon's Adventure Vlog. I hope to see you right back here in a couple days. Now we have to go to the gift shop. Yippee!